So we're in York, Pennsylvania today, and we're talking about how we can better support our veterans. These are the folks that have put their lives on the line to secure our freedoms. There are too many veterans that are homeless. A lot of times they're suffering from the effects of what they saw and experienced in their military service. And so there's a legislation in Harrisburg to try to help that situation, to create an ombudsman, a person that's an advocate that can help connect folks to housing, and in some cases to provide some assistance so that they can secure that housing. Sometimes they need food assistance. In Mercer County, the Community Food Warehouse participates in the Military Share Program. Last year, they provided 35,000 pounds of food to veterans and veteran families, and they do it separately because there's an importance of dignity here. And a lot of times, you know, these folks are warriors and they don't always seek out the help that they need. And so that Military Share Program is critical. We also talked about, you know, folks suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder or other mental health issues, and sometimes they act out on that. And oftentimes, families are the victims, but they're also the people that want that person to get the help so they can return to be the person that they've known them to be all those years before they experienced what they experienced. And so the importance of what they call veterans courts, and we have that in Mercer County, where, you know, a veteran could be involved with law enforcement, but the district attorney recognizes that that person really needs treatment and assistance. And it's not a get out of jail free card. Really, the easier thing in so many cases, as we heard from a judge and a district attorney who testified today, is for them just to sit in jail for a couple months. The harder thing is for them to avail themselves of the veterans court, where, you know, maybe for 2 years they're followed to make sure that they get the services that they need, that they get the mental health treatment, that they get the job training that they need so they can get back into the workforce. It's been successful. So in York County, they've actually reduced their prison costs by $1.8 million, but at the same time, they have a lower recidivism rate, which means that folks are getting through that program and they're not committing crimes again. So these are some of the things that we can do. And fortunately in Mercer County, like I said, we have a veterans court. It's been very successful. Judge Reed, who was a veteran himself, started it along with others. Now Judge Wallace, also a veteran, has taken up that mantle. These are the things that we can do right by our veterans, to recognize that they have needs that need to be addressed, and to let them know that society, we value them.